Welcome to this video on SelectorsHub interview questions and answers for automation engineer on automation testing. Starting with basics, what are element locators in Selenium WebDriver or other tools? And have you used SelectorsHub tool? Element locators or simply locators are addresses of elements on a web page. We need a correct and unique locator to find an element. For example, a link or an input box in Selenium WebDriver, etc. I've used SelectorsHub. It is a free tool that generates the correct locator on inspecting an element. How to use SelectorsHub? SelectorsHub is a browser extension. First, we need to install SelectorsHub for our browser. For example, for Chrome browser, search SelectorsHub in Chrome Web Store and click on it to add extension. Then we need to restart our browser. Then navigate to our web page, right click on our web element and click on the Inspect Context menu item. This will open the developer tools and SelectorsHub will be on the right hand side. The SelectorsHub tool generates the CSS selector or XPaths in Selenium WebDriver automatically. Then we can just copy our desired locator from SelectorsHub and use it in our automation testing script. The next question can be, but what if the web element is in an iframe? Iframes are used to make a website layout. The iframe can be from the same domain or it can be from another domain. That is a cross-origin iframe. For an iframe from the same domain, on inspecting the element, SelectorsHub shows the frame locator as well as the element locator. Now this followers is a cross-origin iframe on my blog called Software Testing Space. You can see that this frame belongs to blogger.com and the web page domain is blogspot.com. They are different. Now for an element in a cross-origin iframe, SelectorsHub usage is that we right-click on the element, hover to SelectorsHub, and then we can copy relative XPath or relative CSS selector, etc. The next question can be, but our web pages also have shadow DOM. Does SelectorsHub work with shadow DOM elements? Yes, we can use SelectorsHub shadow DOM feature. An element in shadow DOM cannot be accessed using XPath. So we have to use SelectorsHub CSS selector in Selenium WebDriver, etc. On inspecting this element, SelectorsHub says that it's in shadow DOM and it gives an alert. This element is inside shadow DOM which can't be accessed through XPath. And it gives a CSS selector. SelectorsHub also gives a code to access that element. We can copy this code and paste and edit it in our script. By the way, I have explained SelectorsHub features in detail and shown many examples in my SelectorsHub latest tutorials. You can view them from the links in the description or the I button in this video. Next in SelectorsHub automation testing interview questions and answers. Can you find locators in Selenium WebDriver, Java, etc. for SVG elements? Yes, SVG is scalable vector graphics format for images. On inspecting an SVG element, SelectorsHub says that it's an SVG element and gives the alert, this is an SVG element and it doesn't support standard XPath format. So it gives a special relative XPath here. SelectorsHub generates this special XPath in Selenium that we can copy to paste in our test automation script. Now in case the SVG element that is visible for a very short time, for example this spin loader in Twitter, we can use SelectorsHub debugger feature to stop the web page and then inspect this SVG. So here also it says it's an SVG element, gives the alert and gives the special XPath. By the way, I have shown this step by step in my Selectors Hub expert level tutorial. Sometimes our menu items disappear from the DOM when you inspect them. How will you find the locator of such a menu item? Debugger is one of the useful Selectors Hub features. By default, it starts after 5 seconds. So for example, on this Uber website, here is the complete address, but if I right click on it, it is going to disappear. So after starting the debugger, if I can make the menu item visible during those 5 seconds by typing something, Selectors Hub will pause the web page. Then I can inspect that element to get the XPath in Selenium WebDriver, etc. Next, in automation testing questions and answers, doesn't it take time to copy and paste the different locators in Selenium WebDriver, etc. automation testing script, and then write the commands? Yes, but Selectors Hub has a command feature to set the driver command. Now for example, we can click here in Selectors Hub to set driver command to append on selectors. This is the driver command, driver.findElement by.xpath xpath value. So Selectors Hub replaces this xpath value keyword with the actual xpath, and here it gives a complete command. And here you can see in the command it gives the actual XPath, and we can copy and paste the entire command in our script. Also, Selectors Hub can generate multiple selectors or multiple commands. So if I inspect the different links one by one and I have set the driver command, I can get all these driver commands here. We just need to inspect all the elements one by one, then copy all the commands to paste in our automation testing script. Next, in testing mock interview questions, can Selectors Hub verify multiple XPaths together on a blank tab? And how will it know that those XPaths exist on any web page or not? The answer is no, Selectors Hub cannot verify multiple XPaths on a blank tab because it doesn't know which XPaths belong to which web page. So the exact same web page to which the XPaths belong must be open at that time. The developer updates the web pages often. Will you verify each locator in your test automation script? No, it is not necessary. Selectors Hub has an XPath healing feature. We can verify multiple selectors from the web page together. The easier way is to paste the entire script and give the driver command in Selectors Hub, and it extracts and verifies each and every locator, like here. Next, in testing interview questions for experienced with Selectors Hub, we are using XPath in our automation testing scripts, but we want to convert them to CSS selectors. How will you do it? In Selectors Hub, we can take the XPath and paste it in the editor and press the Enter key. Then it shows another row for the SH selector, which is the CSS selector for that XPath. Another question can be that you are asked to open Selectors Hub and then turn off auto-generated selectors toggle button in Selectors Hub. Then they may ask you to write the XPath of a web element without auto-generated selectors. Now, even when this auto-generated selectors toggle is off, the suggestions are still on. So start typing the XPath. XPath starts with two forward slashes. So for example, if you have to write the XPath of this enter email, so you can inspect it in the developer tools and start writing two forward slashes input, and Selectors Hub will give the suggestions. So look for a stable attribute, maybe ID or name, but it should say the count as 1, meaning the XPath will be unique for that element. And in interview, you may get a question, what are XPaths functions in Selenium? Actually, there are many XPath functions and many functions for CSS selectors also. You should read them on the SelectorsHub website. That's all in this video. Next time, I will explain and show more awesome testing tools. So please subscribe to the Software and Testing Training channel. Thank you.